Made us spot a so funny fool. I don't really know how to write an exploit or find a bug, but I can play with Metasploit. And from time to time, I do this. The first time I played with Metasploit, I was completely lost. But now I know much more about coding and also more about an exploit. Not enough to teach you something, but I can show you what I do. So first we will start with Windows and Windows 10, and it's the newest version, so you can think it will be hard to really break into this system. So this is more example of a reverse shell or something like this. We will create an executable file, copy this to the target device, execute this, and then this executable will create a connection to Metasploit, and then we can, when we have the control about the system, more or less. So first we create this executable. I do it. Yeah, and how about it's Windows? Yeah, you see here it is. So this will create an executable, and we will put it on a folder temp. It will take a while. You have to enter the remote IP address. And now I will run a web server to copy this to my target device. I use Python for this. So I run Python on this port. Now I can go to my target device. Before I can download this, I have to disable all the security stuff. Almost it's the Windows Defender. Now we have to go to our web server and we can download this file. So also here we have said, keep it anyway. So you see it's hard to download it even. But I think we got it. So now we have to create the backend Metasploit, so we can execute this executable and then we connect to Metasploit. So this is something like use exploit multi handle. Shall we already load the no, I won't have an other payload. Payload is why I could not autocomplete. Payload our code will be executed if you have a bug, and it will be executed by the exploit, hopefully. Windows, and there can be other shells, or I always use Metaprator or some simple reverse shell. I have to set the host, which is my IP. And I have to set the listen port, which I have set to 555. And now I can run it. So now if I execute this, hopefully you will see. Oh, yeah, we have a lot of security. Yes, and you see now I am onto VSTC, so I can ping system info and set Windows 10, and I can do a lot of stuff like logging, get some screenshot of it. Maybe this is funny. And now I will take a screenshot on the misdirection. And yeah, okay, I won't show you it. The next example will be a little bit more realistic. For this we will use even older version of Windows, Windows XP. Then we will use Internet Explorer, so we usually have to interact with some data, and we can create a vendable link. So if a user click onto this link, it will be using vendability inside Internet Explorer 6, and we will execute the exploit, which will allow you to load the payload, and then you get connection to Metasploit. It sounds maybe complicated, but you will see it's not that complicated. First, we open Metasploit, and then we have to configure the payload and the exploit and all this stuff. And after that, we have to use Internet Explorer 6 and visit the link, and then you see we will have your control over the system. So now we'll use another exploit. Windows browser. So and I already said the right payload. Now you only have to configure this. Listen host again is our one. We can set the listen port. And now we have to configure the exploit, where we set the host, which is already our device. And we set the port to 80, so it's the default port for HTTP. And we set the this. You can already, I think, show options like this, and there you see what you have configured and what are your options you can do. It's clear. And now we can simple type exploit. And there it is. It start the server the job for handling the URL. And now if I open Internet Explorer, gotcha. Enter, and you see Metaprinter session 1 open. So that means there's a session in background, so with L we can list with session, with E we can interact with the session ID 1, and sysinfo installs Windows XP. Our next exploit, this is something in the data exchange from Windows XP. So again, we run this console. And by the way, where we have to know, we should know the IP address of our target device. So it's a 4045. Yeah. Now we use the exploit, I think Windows. So you can show the options, what have you to configure. We have the list host and the port, which is okay. And now we only have to set the remote host that we already And now, hopefully, we only have to run X, Y. And there it is. We are into the system. And yeah, now you know why using Linux XP is a bad idea, and it was a bad idea a few years ago. So don't use Windows XP, but I think I don't have to say that. It is obviously. So again, now we will use Windows 10, but we will activate the security. So why not? Yeah. Always better to have security activated. We will do this. And you can probably think, if I now try to execute this file, Windows Defender final and of it will automatically delete this, I think. Obviously I couldn't execute it, I think. Maybe I can. Yeah. So yeah, now it's deleted. For the next example, we will use Python. So I've installed Python on our target system, and it's already not a real world example, but something that could be something that is interesting, and I try it and I find out how I get this working, so I will share it. Again, we will build some kind of executable. In our case, which will be a plain Python script. And this Python script, if it's executed from Python, will create a connection to Metasploit. And we will already store this executable on our device, on the web server, so the real device will load directly into the memory, so it will not be safe on the target device. So how can we do this? So first we have to create the executable file, and this will be Python. Yes, I think this will be right. So say we'll listen how support and all the stuff we do before. We run the Python web server. Now we go into Metasploit and configure again the multi-handle, so not the real exploit, only the handle of a payload. And then we have to execute the Python script on the target device. Simple as that. So use but now we have to set the payload to the Python metapreter shell. So I think Python GCP set all these parameters like before. Yeah, and there, this is everything we have to specify. Now we run exploit. You can, yeah. Now we go on the target device and have to execute. We have to get the file from the web server. We can browse to it. So if you see this, you see this is the code. If this code will be executed with Python on this device, and we will get a connection to Metasploit. backend, HTTP. Hopefully everything is right. Yeah, you see, we created Metasploit connection and running Metasploit, running Windows Defender, our security on the newest version of Windows 10. But you see, you have already, or you have to make the user interact that you will execute this. And I think if you call someone and say, please type this into the PowerShell, no one will do it. So this is already a really abstract example to see how you can use Metasploit with other payloads from Python or from almost every other language. I think for every language will be in payload which will connect to Metasploit. So yes, I think this was everything I want to show you. Yeah, hope you enjoyed, hope you have some fun. For me it was a lot of fun to play with Metasploit as I compare this to my first try to run some tools like this. This was so painful and I get stuck so many times and I was so frustrated that I don't try it again, and yeah, that was it. Now, a few years later, a few more years later, it was really easy and make a lot of fun. And I think the next goal is to find a real bug and write your own exploit. But I think this will take a quite. It will take a while until I get this. So yeah, I hope for. Thanks for watching my video. If you like it, share this video, like and comment, and hopefully we will see us again in another video. Have a nice day.